First up, we have Mark Thienpont, who's a lead expert on BI and HANA, and he's representing Delaware Consulting, the company he's worked for, and he's going to come up and talk about transformation and what that means for your applications. Come on up, Mark. I'm on top of the world. Changing the format up, we're gonna sit down.
Yeah, that's better.
Well, thank you for joining us here in Basel.
Thrilled to be here.
Excited to have Delaware here. You've got a lot of things planned. We heard a little bit from Mark earlier on SAP and all the work that SAP is doing to transform both their organization but their partners. What does that mean for a company like Delaware? Maybe walk us through a little bit about what Delaware Consulting does.
Well, Delaware has as the mission over the last 15 years actually to implement vendor software like from SAP and from Microsoft at customers. So we are an integration partner for a lot of that one. So if you see that SAP is now moving towards Cloud Foundry, naturally we will follow that kind of thing with the products that SAP is delivering. So that means a lot to us to be much more open sourced as a kind, so that we can also use all those challenging new languages and challenging new databases around that we were not able to do before. So I'm happy to see that in the last 20 years that I worked with SAP products, actually that they moved from, well, open source, we don't want to have it, to open source, that's going to be our standard. So that's quite cool to see.
So that must be exciting for your customers as well, as your engagement and involvement in the open source communities.
Well, what we see coming is the last year specifically, we see a lot of requests for innovation, actually. So customers come to us and say, help us out for certain cases. And we have a twofold. Customers that actually already have ideas what they want to do. Last week, we had a customer still running on a mainframe, for Christ's sake, and they wanted to do something with blockchain. So help us out.
How mainframe do we to blockchain,
that's a great thing.
That's a transformation. Yeah.
So we have those kind of customers who have ideas. And we have a bunch of customers who don't have ideas. And we help them out also, like where do you start your transformation, what is possible, et cetera, et cetera. And well, the open cloud platform will give us a lot of possibilities over there.
Well, walk us through the process then. If I'm on a mainframe today and I want to start using cloud native technologies or blockchain, what does that process look like and how does Delaware Consulting help them get there?
Well, we have a threefold of possibilities there. What we do today is actually bring our customers together. We have 450 active customers. We selected some of them that wanted to join a community this year. And we call it the Dell 20, Delaware 20 innovation customers. And we bring them together every month to sit together to talk about their problems, what they want to innovate in their business process. And actually, they select them for themselves the three best scenarios that we actually work out for them. So that's one scenario that we could use. We actually last week also installed a new service that's called Innovation as a Service. So then we work with the customer itself and try to think about how do you redesign actually your business model. So just starting from an ideation kind of concept, working it through like, okay, this is the pre-authorization, we work it out, and we easily build POCs and mockups and stuff like that. And that's a very interesting way to go through. Just think about if you have guys still having a mainframe. You know, you can imagine that those kind of people still are kind of old-fashioned in a kind of way. How do we make the ideation happen? And you just want to sit together with the decision takers and try to do design thinking. You know, you drag along a lot of paper and the post-it kind of thing, and you start breaking it up. You know, the concrete walls need to drop off. Most of the time, that's working quite well. There's a very interesting kind of conversation that you have there. After a few days, you come up with very new things. Just think outside the box, let's say. And if it doesn't work, we even have an actor on our payroll who can loosen up things a little bit. So we even go that far.
We should have brought one today. Yeah. Everybody excited about things.
And last one, we are thinking about a mobile kind of truck that we have everything installed just to give ideas what is possible, so that you have a wall with touch screens that you can work with, Internet of Things that is being installed, etc., etc., so that in a five-day period we could actually build a mock-up based on their ideas. So that's a little bit the way that we are working today.
That's great. So you're taking them from, you know, I want an idea to an idea quickly.
Yeah, that's going pretty fast. Now, one of the experiments that we did, and I was quite happy that I saw on the blackboard here, the idea of, well, you need to have a landscape, you need to have the technology, but you also have to change the culture and your business model. We once did, and the diversity of the people involved. We once did an experiment with just put a data scientist and a technical guy knowing the business a lot, so a business consultant, a data scientist, and a millennial in one office, just for a day and a half, and give them the assignment, you build something completely out of the blue, doesn't matter which language you use, they use JavaScript, so that was cool, and they come up with a very bright idea. So just saying, like, if you see that the development that the data scientist was doing while they were discussing, you know, the interaction between you see things moving on a screen versus I have a new business model idea is quite great. So that's actually the way we are going. We are building while we are making the ideation. The combination of Cloud Foundry as a platform with all the new possibilities and all the new tools that SAP is delivering out of the box, which is very easy to customize and wrap it up, you know, the self-service kind of part. And I want to thank them also for the SAP Data Hub that they just launched a couple of weeks ago. This is something that's quite amazing. It's very rapidly that you can deliver something that they say, yeah, that's a quite thing to work from there, actually.
Well, as we think about, you know, once you have the idea and you start thinking about the ideation past that, but I think what's also important, you pointed out, is really taking an idea and put it into making it a reality and putting it out there. As we think about applications and cloud native application architectures, what is the role that you see both your company, but where do you see that going and the impact that has on an organization?
For us, it will be mostly we will follow what SAP is doing, and we are not really software vendors and ourselves, but I see that changing. Right now, we are really working with customer cases. They pay for the time that we spend, and then that's their property. But I think that will change over time. I think we will make it more broad, bring customers together, have the same ideas, and maybe propose something that we can sell to a broader community. So for us, that might have a severe impact altogether. For the cloud kind of part, for innovation that we did the last couple of years, it was most of the time that we proposed we go to SAP Cloud Platform or to Microsoft. We always have to have also the Azure kind of thing alongside. For customers that want to go that way, there are still a few that just say no. Okay, we work alongside that one. But most of the customers are really pleased to have the cloud as a solution for that one. And we actually also mingle them. We just mingle SAP customers with Microsoft and even have a hybrid kind of solution for that.
It looks like cloud is here to stay.
Yeah. Definitely.
It's a thing.
A good thing.
As we wrap up, where do you see the next 12 months taking you with, you know, Cloud Platform now being out there and, you know, your portfolio evolving? Where do you see the next 12 months going?
I think about the new products that SAP is now delivering on Cloud Platform. I think there will be a huge roadmap and demo kind of thing. And with that innovation truck rolling over, I think that will be my main activity for the next 12 months. Just make demos, make mockups, and just start kicking off the innovation kind of part. There's a lot of things in IoT because just onboarding the digital twin is the first step you have to do. But think what you can do afterwards with machine learning, combining with system of records, and visual integration and stuff like that. I think that will be about it for the next 12 months, actually.
Sounds like you have a lot planned for this year.
Great, isn't it?
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Mark, here on
You're
stage
welcome.
In Basel. We appreciate you coming by.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.